The Sanders Foundation received the books as a gift from Air Canada Vacations, which in turn obtained them from passengers and staff. The books represent the first such donation by Sanders Foundation to the Crisis Centre. But the foundation says it's the start of things to come.
Today is not only about donating the books to the St. Lucia Crisis Center to aid with the after-school program, but it's really the start of a long-term relationship with the Crisis Center. We're delighted to be here and we're delighted to be a part of the projects that the Crisis Center will undertake in the future.
The books, covering various themes, were gratefully received by the Crisis Center, which felt the donation was coming at an appropriate time when St. Lucia is observing Reading Month.
We've been struggling all these years trying to help our people out there, to help stop the whole issue of abuse of one from another. And we've gone into a number of projects and we need all the assistance that we can get.
The books will be used in the Crisis Center after school program for about 40 students engaged in academic and other activities at the center.
I have three sons coming there after school, and I'm glad that they come in, and I thank you for Crisis Center to give my children lessons and to give them the little help they're given. So I praise in them and thank you, and God may be help them.
I have three children coming here to the Crisis Center for the after school program. I'm very glad they will be coming here, because when I'm not at home, they'll have a place to be. From work, I will meet up with them, so I'm glad they are coming to the Crisis Center.
Just recently, the United States Embassy contributed $17,000 to the Crisis Center to buy computers and other equipment to furnish a resource room for its after-school program for children aged 6 to 16. And Carrasco and Sons, who owns the building that the Crisis Center occupies, is allowing the bottom section to be used as an extended resource room for the students. For the DBS News World, Melissa Pori.